Hello, beer troopers, and welcome to another beer review with me, Peter, the master of hops. Today, checking out some more beer from Verdant, a fantastic brewer in England, in Cornwall, and we're not drinking haze from them, which they're known for. We're drinking an English IPA. I've talked about this a lot. Like, I've been wishing for more classic English styles and revisiting them and trying more classic English beer because it was the types of beer that got me into beer. And I've had this kind of throwback thing with revisiting a lot of the greats that were great back in the day, and then some are still great and some are not. And it's really fun. And some of these like really nice English beers are just banging. Like, also a brewery I really want to revisit is The Kernel. Man, I used to love their beer. But yeah, we're checking out Verdant's Bissau. This is their attempt at an English style IPA. They do this in cask as well, or on cask, which is awesome. And it's made with UK grown Harlequin hops and Cascade. 5.3%. And you know, that's, I think that's really cool. And you can see, as you can see by the color, they brought crystal malt into the game, and that's what you usually have in English IPAs. You have a bit of crystal malt and whatnot. They say themselves that the flavors they get out of this is biscuit, toast, and toffee with an earthy and floral hop character. And the Cascade comes from Restall Farm in Kent, and the Harlequin comes from one of Charles Farram's affiliated farms in Herefordshire, I think that's how you say it. And Charles Farram is a hop broker, and I guess also then affiliated with growing hops. And apparently Harlequin is one of these attempts at making modern British hops that are more fruity and tropical and things like that. I've never tried it, so this is going to be my first time experiencing it. That hop in the beer. I picked up Bissau on Beer Dome, so thanks a ton to Beer Dome for the beer. They had a nice selection of Verdant beers, and this was on there. I was like, oh, I should check this out. And I didn't get any of the hazy stuff. I just got this. So this will be fun. Like, yeah, come on, classic English IPA. So it looks great in glass. You know, this kind of rust orange hue. It's got a bit of a beige-ish off-white head and a little bit of sediment. I wonder if this has been hazy. I don't know. It looks nice to see the aroma. Smells freaking quintessentially English. I love this. I'm getting like marmalade vibes, peach marmalade. Definitely toffee, biscuit, digestive, crackers, or graham cracker. Like a toffee note, like really peachy marmalade to me. Definitely floral, I see that too. Earthiness, some spice. Kind of a nettly note. This smells like a lot like a really fairly, like, I think it's around 2 months in the can, this one. It smells like a fairly fresh take on English IPA. Like, with the back in the day when I got English IPAs, they've been on shelf for like 8 months or something like that. Like, in the early days of craft beer, and I didn't bat an eye because I didn't know much about the freshness back in the day, but this smells really good. Really loving this, like, stone fruity, peachy, marmalade thing. Well, let's try it. Cheers. Thanks to Beardon for the beer. Ooh, there's some bitterness to it as well. More than I expected. Actually, a good amount of bitterness. Almost like what you associate with more classic West Coast type beer. Wow. Well, English IPAs can also be bitter. I wonder, I'm really curious about the IBU content on this. I think it's also a case of the flavor profile makes it seem more bitter. It's dry, and there's definitely more like earthy, spicy, floral on the palate. And I think that's maybe why you're also perceiving it as being more bitter. But it's like, there's so much quintessentially English about it. But there's also something that reminds me of classic American IPA, because it's like a little bit resiny too, and stuff like that. And then like this drying, bitter, like black peppery finish. Yeah, the nose, I'm really picking up on that stone fruit. But I'm also getting a little bit like a bit more of a resiny thing now. And I think there's a little bit of the marmalade yeast character, but it's not super stone fruity now. I'm getting more of like a grapefruit marmalade, actually. It definitely has a little bit of an history of like a sweet fruitiness. Not as much as like some classic English IPAs have more. Like, this is really hop forward and biscuity. It's like blurring lines between almost like classic English IPA and but also American IPA. But that's probably also because of the Cascade. Cascade is one of the most OG, you know, American hops. And having a UK grown variety of that in there will, of course, also make you think of classic sea hop beers. Like, if you're thinking of taps around the UK, this could definitely rival, like, Sierra Nevada taps. Like, if you have this instead of Sierra Nevada Pale Ale, for example, it's not, like, completely similar, because there's definitely something more British about this, because there's a bit of that toffee and crackery notes, and there's a bit more of that yeasty kind of marmalade-y thing. But still, it's pretty banging English IPA. I was really not expecting this bitterness, though. But this is very nice. And 5.3% is a nice ABV as well. It tastes like how beers used to taste, but more hoppiness. This is a great take on English IPA. Really nice. I've got, actually, some English Pale Ale. Or is it English IPA? I'm not sure now. I've got one from Copenhagen Commons to try as well. A Danish brewery that also likes to dive into more classic styles. But this is really good. I'm going to go straight 90 for Biso. This is awesome. This is very nice. Really refreshing. Really crushable. I could drink a lot of this. I bet this is banging on cask. And I'm guessing they've actually tried to can condition this, because there is quite a few floaties. Oh, wow. Look at that. That's almost a bit too much now. That looks, you can't see that. There's like a lot of floaties. I usually don't like to pour that in, but like, it's cool that they like tried to do something like that. I'm not sure it's because it was hazy when it was released or whatnot, but like that's like yeast clumped together. But what's really fun, like back in the day, you'd see a lot of UK breweries and classic breweries being like, this is bottle conditioned beer, like, taste evolution and all this stuff. You don't see anyone preaching about that anymore. But that used to be like a quality stamp from a lot of brewers when we used to get English beers, like, this is bottle conditioned and it's gonna be so much better than a filtered beer. So, but this is very nice. So yeah, straight 90. Mm. Next time I'm in the UK, I need to try and find this on cask. So yeah, 94 Biso by Verdant. Very nice stuff. I definitely recommend you guys to check this out. I think they also just put out an even fresher batch than this because it was really well received. So check that out. And yeah, I love the idea of using the you know, English grown Cascade, classic American hop, paired with a more modern UK hop, instead of using EKG and Fuggles and like some of these really, really old school ones. But yeah, if you had Biso, let me know what you thought of it. And as always, remember to comment, subscribe, check out the Facebook fan page, Twitter, and Instagram. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and ring the bell for future notification about videos. And yeah, check out Beardo. Link from the shop is down below. I'm going to say cheers and see you guys in the beer review.